पंडरपुर कैंप।
हरी बोल,
हरी बोल,
हरी बोल। ओके,
सो हियर वी आर विथ हर ग्रेस युगल प्रिया माताजी। आई वुड लाइक टू गिव अ स्मॉल इंट्रोडक्शन अबाउट माताजी। एक्चुअली द इंट्रोडक्शन इज स्मॉल, बट यू नो इन डिटेल यू कैन गो ऑन स्पीकिंग अबाउट माताजी। So it's a great pleasure to introduce someone who is so dear, respectable, someone so full of wisdom and clarity in thoughts, none other than Her Grace Yugal Priya Mataji.
Hari Bol.
Mataji graduated in 2001 from the reputed Sydenham College, Mumbai. Actually, KC College, Sydenham College, and one more college was there, Mataji. HR. I am from KC. They were all, you know, like near, yes, nearby all colleges. So all, you know, everyone would like to see who one wants to go in KC, HR, Sydenham and all. So I was in KC, but I am very junior to Mataji. So Mataji is from Sydenham College, Mumbai, which is where the Touch of Devotees Association transformed her life. Means she started, Mataji started in Sydenham College, her bhakti, and also her prosperous future. Mataji has worked in stock depth markets in BSE for 7 years and also as an international recruiter for 3 years for a London-based company while pursuing her spiritual practices simultaneously. In temple, Mataji is involved in children's summer camp. Actually, Mataji is first from Sri Sri Radha Gopinath temple, and then Mataji shifted to Pune NVCC temple. So over there, Mataji is involved in children's summer camps, girls' training sessions, cultivating and grooming them to be a better woman overall in line with our Vedic culture. She is involved in services for the maintenance of this beautiful, our ISKCON NVCC temple, traveling around Mumbai, Pune, Belgaum, Bangalore for girls' camps. She, along with her husband, has been counselors for the last 14 years, guiding and counseling many couples in Pune for leading a wholesome, satisfied married lives and various other aspects of life as well. They both travel to Bangalore regularly for the same purpose. Mataji is also currently, by the blessings of a spiritual master, she is involved in rendering weekly classes on scriptures like Srimad Bhagavatam, Bhagavad Gita and the lives of Vaishnava saints to the esteemed ladies of Pune congregation. She personally feels that the blessings of devotees whom she is trying to please along with her husband is her real wealth. I repeat. She personally feels that the blessings of devotees whom she is trying to please along with her husband is her real wealth, much more than the stock markets and recruitment business commissions. So can we all put a loud Hari Bol and welcome Yugal Priya Mataji.
Hari Bol! Hari Bol! Hari Bol!
Thank you so much, Mataji, for being here with us. We are really so fortunate to have you with us. In the morning, actually, when you were speaking there, few girls told me that, you know, we can feel that vibration. Really, how many felt that? Hari Bol! Hari Bol! Thank you so much, Mataji.
Bye.
Few more thing I want to add regarding Mataji's seva.
Introduction?
No, detailed seva that you are doing. Mataji is engaged in dressing the deities, making Sayan Bhog, Sandhya Bhog, and Mataji takes 5 classes in a week for Mataji's.
Hari Bol!
Hare Krishna. Thank you so much. Let's begin with prayers. Om Agyan Timirandasya Gyananjana Shalakaya Chakshurur Militam Yena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Shri Chaitanya Manobhishtam Sthapitam Yena Bhutale Swayam Rupa Kadamayam Dadati Svavadantikam Vandeham Shri Guru Shri Yuta Padakamalam Shri Guru Vaishnavamscha श्रीरूपं साग्रजातां सहगणा रघुनाथान्वितं तं सजीवं साद्वैतं सावधूतं परिजनासहितं कृष्णचैतन्यदेवं
Shri Radha Krishna Padan Sahagana Lalita Shri Vishakhadvitamsha He Krishna Karuna Sindhu Dina Bandhu Jagatpate Gopesha Gopika Kanta Radha Kanta Namaste Tapta Kanchana Gaurangi Radhe Vrindavaneshwari Vrishabhanu Sute Devi Pranamami Hari Priye Vancha Kalpatarubhyascha Kripa Sindhubhya Evacha Patitanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavebhyo Namo Namaha Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shri Vasadi Gaura Bhakta Vrinda Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama 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 Hare 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 Krishna So I hope you have good. You all had good rest, good darshan.
Yes.
How many of you all did not rest? Koi hat. There was no scope. You had to rest. So welcome to Pandharpur Dham. As I said in the morning, this beautiful dham is non-different than the Nada Brahma. Brahma means the accumulation of the existence, the entire accumulation of the existence. So when we say Nada Brahma, it means it's the entire accumulation, the accumulation effect which it has of the sound vibrations. And when we say sound vibrations, it could be any, like abhi yahan par koi DJ bajne lagega. So you know that's also sound vibration. But that agitates our hearts. But the spiritual sound vibrations, it soothes our soul. Right? So sound vibration, when I say, it's all about the spiritual vibration that satisfies our souls. So that's why this place is called non-different than Nada Brahma, where there's constant singing of the Lord's holy names. And you must have observed while walking on the path, while going to the temple, we were constantly singing. And although in the main Rukmini temple, Vittal Rukmini temple, we could not get that much time to stand in front of the Lord because Mahapya Tirupati Kitara Jargandi, Jargandi, Jargandi. That was applicable here as well. So we walked off from there, but then we carried the impressions deep within our hearts, hope so. And then we landed up by Krishna's mercy at Takpita Vithoba temple, where we had an intense kirtan to our heart's content. You all agree?
Haribol.
So those vibrations sitting in front of the Lord, offering our heart's devotion, offering our intense prayers, is an irreplaceable opportunity in the life. Because I remember when I started my Krishna consciousness way back, I was introduced when I was like first, second standard. But then, I'm from Hyderabad, by the way. Nobody told that about me. So I must tell that. So I have an identity crisis. I'm an Andhraite, born and brought up in many places all over India. So my father was an army and he was also into railway. So he always had a transferable job. But I've stayed in Talagadda, studied in St. Mary's schools and Medipatnam, Langara House, Ring Road. These are like my Karwan. So these are the places I've spent my childhood times. So I got introduced on my 7th or 8th birthday by my Masi. And we were shifting to different places. We were hopping different places. And when I was in Hyderabad, my father was not so favorable towards Krishna consciousness. I remember still he used to hold my mouth like this and puso onion garlic and I'm like, no, I don't want it. But then as a child, I hardly had any control over it. So once I shifted to Bombay for my studies, which is in 1999, I guess. So for Sydenham College. So by the way, Sydenham, if you all know, I don't know whether you know or not, but Sydenham is a very reputed college which hosts the ex-alumni like Hrithik Roshan, Juhi Chawla, and you know, the entire Bollywood category comes into that college because it's a hub of all extracurricular activities. A personality development is like very, very natural when you enter into Sydenham. So coming from that background, I was really not very much into a very favorable situation to practice Krishna consciousness, right, from my family background. And college, though, you know, it's anyways going to be always hep. So I was working also in stock markets, right, from my 12th standard. So it was not very easy. So whenever I would go for Maharaj Yatras, it was like an intense call because it was so difficult to get out of the material entanglement that I was into because it would suck the energy. The markets would suck, the family would suck, the college would suck. and the peer pressure would suck the energy and would always be divided between ye karu ki wo karu, ye chahiye ki wo chahiye. And when you have something in surplus, you're really not able to make a decision, right? Because you know it's anyways there. Main yahan se yahan turn karu to waise bhi rehne wala hai. But jo chhutne wala hota hai, uske liye dil bhagta hai. Right? Because ye time kabhi nahi aayega, college ka time kabhi nahi aayega, friends ka time, hangout time, marine drive time. Like we used to have marine drive evenings because Sydenham is like just on the ocean side. So we used to have marine drive evenings. So that's like recently, I think 2 years ago, I met up with my college friends, Charu and Vineet. So Charu is abroad and she's a Citibank director there in New York. And Vineet is a businessman in Bangalore. So we caught up like after 20 years and we did not miss to go to Marine Drive and spend an evening there and hang out, eating. Jo hum log pehle college ke dinon mein khate the, you know, sandwich ek dusre ke plate mein se khana. Of course, after the Kanti, after initiation, after Brahman Diksha, now you're like, you know, two minds, should I do this or not? But then, you know, these are the people who really supported you all throughout because I was working. I was like really falling short on my assignments. Because I would not spend after 10 the day at college because I had to be in the office at BSc. So like that, we had so many memories. So life has always been a mixture of all these elements. It's never going to be straight Krishna consciousness. And it's never going to be like, you know, very pure material life. I'm sure all you girls also go through this. It's always a confusion, dilemma between should I do this or that. Although, you know, this is an eternal source of happiness. But the mind and the body and the senses always hanker for something that which the world recognizes for. So that's that. That dvandva is always going to remain. So I'm sharing this to give that hope to all of you that don't become disappointed if you have that dilemma, if you have that confusion, because it's part of life, it's part of everyone's growth. But the focus is very important. So when we used to go for yatras, like such yatras, I knew this is exclusive pure Krishna consciousness. This moment I'm not going to get back ever in my life. So I remember sitting in Man Mandir when Maharaj would, like at about 10:30 at night, he would have those intense kirtans. So jo sara 355 days ka jo pain hota tha na, wo is 10 din ki yatra mein nikalta tha. Like it's a place to cry out. It's a place to express your heart to your master. That, my dear Lord, this is what I face when I'm back to my karma kshetra, when I'm back to my karma bhumi. But this is the place where I want to be just myself, where I focus on my relationship with you and I want to put myself so plain and clear and unadulterated in front of you that you empower me before I go back. We express that kind of crying in front of the Lord so that when we go back, we are better equipped to face life. So dhams and the yatras, like I remember, I think last year you all went to GV. Right, so GV is also not different than Vrindavan. So when you come for these camps, it's not just a 2 day spent in the, you know, association of friends or under the guidance of your mentors. It's not just a yet another opportunity for time pass or to do fun. That's all a part of it. Giggling, dancing, yes, a part of it. वो हो ही जाता है. चलते चलते भी लड़कियों को giggling बोलने के लिए ज़रूरत ही नहीं होती है. They just it comes naturally to them, right? But then that, you know, that focus from the heart has to be made an effort for. It has to be made an effort for. So when you come to these dhams, these sanghas, don't take them for granted. It's an opportunity that on your own you may never get to do again. Because the difference between kirtan and sankirtan, how many of you enjoy japa? Hey Bhagwan! What an honest audience! Tomorrow morning we should sit together and chat, okay? Because japa is also a very beautiful thing. So what if I don't like it? It doesn't. It's always like, you know, so what if I'm not Aishwarya Rai? But then the beauty exists. You all agree?
Yes.
So what if I don't enjoy japa? The real beauty of enjoying japa exists. I always believed into this. So what if I don't have something? That doesn't make the thing little less important. Right? That beauty, that feeling still exists. So none of us here, no, I should not say that, none, it's a very sad situation, but some of us may enjoy chanting our japa here, but not everyone. But what's the difference between kirtan and sankirtan? How many of you like kirtan? Some hands at least, yeah, please. Right? So it's very natural because when you're struggling with something just by yourself, it's very difficult to overcome the challenges. It's very difficult to get the taste for it. But when you're together, it's very natural. Right? So association really brings that power within us. It unleashes that power within us. So when we come to the dham, on our own, we may be struggling like cats and dogs back in our places. But then when we are in the association of devotees, we get that power to offer our sincere prayers to the Lord. And believe me, anything, like I said in Thakvitavitoba temple, that luxury and other facilities, the designations, all these are what? Just part of life. But what is the essence of life?
Devotion.
Devotion is the essence of life. So that is unveiled when you come in such association. So everything else may come and go. But these moments where you are sincerely trying to explore the pure nectar of devotional service, devotion to Lord Krishna, it will be best revealed to you when you are sincerely sitting amongst all the other devotees. Because wo ek dusre ke saath borrow hota hai. I always tell this in my classes. We have like 3-4 classes as they mentioned, so we have different 3-4 hosts. So jo jis ghar mein baith ke shanti se dhyan se sunta hai na, and the host is always busy making arrangements. So I always tell them at the end of it and at the beginning of it, so I'm also going to share with you. Although this is a public place, doesn't matter much to us after tomorrow. But then when you listen to any class or any inputs about Krishna consciousness very sincerely, spiritual life, you know, very sincerely, till the time you're seated on your, you know, designated places, you just grasp it to your soul. You grasp it to the level of taking it to your heart and soul. And the minute the class gets over, what happens? You just become a little distracted, right? You're like, okay, chalo, ab ho gaya, ab kya hai next? So the minute you get up, what happens? You just lose it. As if you're depositing in the ground where you sat. And then just walk up. I mean, you stand up and just walk off. Never even looking back. This is the place which has absorbed all the Krishna consciousness where I was sitting and listening. So I always tell the listeners, please don't do that mistake. When you get up from here, take back the points which you have heard. Otherwise, only the host house will become Vaikuntha. Because all your vibrations will be deposited on that floor, on that tile. Which is whose house? The host house. Aake kaun sun raha hai? Tum. Aur benefit kisko ja raha hai?
Host.
Chalega? Thoda chal sakta hai. 50-50 chal jayega. Thoda parokkar. Right, but then we should also take back what we have been hearing. Otherwise, it's like hum baithe sune aur jo bhi suna punya dan kar diya. Isliye mandir mein wo pratha hoti thi, pata hai aapko? Baithne ki. Like I used to never understand. You know, my nani, masi, and dadi, they would take us to the temples in the childhood, and then hum darshan lete the aur humko lagta tha, okay, chalo. And what they would say, no, touch your buttock to the floor. You know, it was as good as that bigger ritual, that least a ritual, I would say. For them, the understanding was, you should at least touch it, baithna chahiye. What do you mean by baithna chahiye? To hear, sit and hear Upanishad. Means you sit near the Guru and hear from them. So when we are having so many opportunities in ISKCON where we sit and hear, now our relatives can't dare to say this to us because we sit for so long. We have taken it to the other extreme. Right, where they would hardly touch their, you know, buttocks to the ground, but now they are like sitting so much to the ground and grasping everything that's coming from the speaker and the spiritual sound vibration that is directly touching there. So now our relatives have to tell, kab aayegi, kab uthegi, kab uth, right? So that's the whole purpose. So this is the spirit behind every ritual. Coming from an Andhra background, the mother would always tell me, kadapalaku pasukukma pettu. And I was like, why this ritual has to be there every 15 days? Because it takes away my playing time. Because mama has to cook, so I have to do that. And I'm like, why this Amavasya comes? Why this Purnima comes? Why this festival? Why this Ugadi comes? Because it takes away my playing time. It's only by Prabhupada's grace that I entered into Krishna consciousness. And then I started to realize whatever my mom taught me, it had the reason behind it. Unfortunately, she didn't know. But Prabhupada gave me the spirit. My mother gave, I always tell this by Krishna's mercy, with a little bit of pride, that with true pride, that my mother gave me the rituals coming from a very conservative background, and my eternal master, Srila Prabhupada, spiritual master, Param Shiksha Guru of ISKCON, gave me the spirit behind the ritual. And that's how my life became spiritual. Because rituals are always backed up by the spirit. If our parents don't know of it, I can't say it's their mistake. Right? It's just that they don't know of it. But you have the ritual, just have the spirit and get it connected. You have that intelligence, right? Your parents, they say, itna bada ghoda banaya, khud bhi kuch karo. Like today I tell my mother, you know, why to do that? And I do it myself. So these are the small things. So don't take anything in life for granted. So when you get up from here, What's your task?
Take back
what you have heard, वरना इसका भला हो जाएगा. जो हमें प्रॉब्लम नहीं है आप रख लो 20-30%, बट 60-70% वी हैव टू टेक बैक विद ourselves. Rest up, बाकी आसमान में डिपॉजिट करो, एयर में डिपॉजिट करो, ग्रास में डिपॉजिट करो, दैट्स योर चॉइस, दैट्स एनीवेज गोना हैपन. ओके, सो दिस प्लेस पंढरपुर इज नॉट डिफरेंट देन नाद ब्रह्म, एंड तिरुपति इज नोन एज अन्नब्रह्म, एंड पुरी इज नोन एज तिरुपति बालाजी लड्डू. आई थिंक हैज इट्स वेरी ग्रेट इम्पैक्ट ऑन ऑल ऑफ अवर हार्ट्स, के उनके लड्डू हम बहुत खाते हैं. सो पुरी इज कॉल्ड एज अन्नब्रह्म, एंड तिरुपति इज कॉल्ड एज कंचनब्रह्म, वेर पीपल जस्ट कम एंड दे जस्ट यू नो रिलीज देयर गोल्डन ज्वेलरी, ऐसे ही सब उतर जाती है वहां पे, खड़े खड़े उतर जाती है, एंड पीपल जस्ट ऑफर इट टू द हुंडीज, राइट, बिकॉज बालाजी इज द बिगेस्ट बिजनेस पार्टनर इन द एंटायर क्रिएशन. सो सिमिलरली हियर विट्ठल इज ऑल्सो बिगेस्ट बिजनेस पार्टनर, बट नॉट फॉर यू नो द मटीरियल वर्ल्ड बिजनेस दैट वी, द मंडेन बिजनेस दैट वी टॉक अबाउट, बट ही ऑल्सो हैज द बिजनेस, लाइक ही स्टैंडिंग विद हिज हैंड्स ऑन द वेस्ट फॉर वॉट, टू टेक अस back home, back to Godhead. He's standing with so much of patience. So that's his business, to deliver one soul, one after the other. So it's a very, very powerful potential place of Pandharpur Dham. This Dham is referred to in many Puranas, like Skanda and Padma Purana. Lot of references there in about this Dham in these two places. And also it is called as a spiritual capital of Maharashtra. Because every state, our India is so rich with so many temples and cultures and the deities and the sampradayas, that Kerala we have which lord?
Anantapadma.
Very good. Karnataka we have which lord?
Udupi.
Very good. Andhra?
Tirupati.
And which else? Tamil Nadu?
Madurirangam.
Very good. Amazing. Maharashtra?
Vittal.
Right. And Orissa?
Jagannathpuri.
And north? वृंदावन, कृष्णा, एंड ऊपर नॉर्थ में
बद्रीनाथ.
वहां पे तो सारे विराजमान, पूरा मिक्सचर विराजमान है, पूरा इंदुराज विराजमान है वहां पे, राइट. एंड एमपी एंड बिहार एंड ऑल बीच के जो स्टेट, गुजरात,
द्वारकाधीश,
वेरी गुड, डाकोर एंड रणछोड़ ड्राइव, एंड देन व्हाट्स देयर इन द एमपी एंड बिहार एरिया, गया सुना है, राइट, द लोटस फुटप्रिंट ऑफ द लॉर्ड, वेयर द लॉर्ड कम्स टू रिसाइड देयर. And any other places in MP and Bihar? There's Jharkhand forest. So there are deities everywhere. Varanasi is also done almost at the junction of MP and UP. Am I right? It's almost at the junction. So our India, Bharat especially, is filled with this culture of deities in every place. So today you are fortunate to have come to the spiritual capital of Maharashtra, where the Lord is Vitthala. As I already shared in the morning about the story of Pundalik, which we'll not speak about it, but we'll have a beautiful drama. But before that, just some understanding about this place, which I have already given half of it. But we'll see some more understandings, points about this. Tomorrow also, we are planning to go to the other side of the river, which is Chandrabhaga. You saw the ghat, that's called, yes, Prabhupada Ghat, built by His Holiness Loknath Swami Maharaj. It's a very beautiful ghat. It's a very special landmark of the spiritual capital of Maharashtra. So we are going to go to Gopalpur. We are going to go to a place called Janabai Temple, if time permits. And then there is Narad Muni Temple, which no other place Narad Muni's temple exists other than this particular place. So it's under, like, half submerged in water. So we are going to take darshan of all these things, but there are stories attached to it. That's how this place attains its importance. So we'll discuss that. So it is said so there are many devotees also. I'll also refer to them because I may not get a chance. So there are many devotees who are connected to this particular place, which is Pundalik is the first one. Then there's Tukaram, who stays in Dehu, used to stay in Dehu. And on March 25th, he completed 356 years of going back home, back to Godhead. Sir Deha Vaikuntha Padavi, that's how he's referred to as. Sir Deha means when you have to go back home, back to Godhead, what you have to do? First, you have to give up this body. But Tukaram went back. For him, the airplane, the Pushpak Viman came as it is. And he climbed on that Pushpak Viman with this body made up of earth, water, fire, air, and ether. But that was not his material body. He had totally spiritualized his body. Like Srila Prabhupada gives this analogy. What is the analogy Prabhupada gives? That when anything material is in touch with some object or some Krishna consciousness stuff, that becomes totally spiritualized. Any analogy you remember?
Rod and fire.
Very good. Thank you. I'm happy the girls listen. See, apply karo ki nahi karo. Sun ke samajh lo. एप्लीकेशन बाद में, पर कम से कम सुनने के लिए समझ सकते हो ना, या समझने के लिए सुन सकते हो ना. Right, so just hear, understand. Maybe you may not feel that inspiration and the guts to say ki, I mean, I don't relate with it, it's fine. But then at least listen, understand the principle, theory jama kar do. Like mamas keep telling you, right? Cooking kar, shaadi ke baad kya karegi, shaadi ke baad kya karegi. Ab to khane ke din hai, abhi se khilane ke din ki baate kar rahi ho. But mama keeps saying that, repeating that, so that it gets instilled in your brains. And one day when you actually cook, you are able to recollect those words. Similarly, whatever philosophy, you know, our acharyas, your mentors or teachers or the speakers share, even if you don't understand, even if you feel it's irrelevant at this point of time, just hear it. Just listen to it, understand it and store it. And tell yourself, maybe, you know, it's a post-dated check. It's not the check to be realized right away. It's a post-dated check which will be realized later. So Prabhupada says, when you put an iron rod into the fire, iron rod also attains the features of fire. So has the iron rod become fire?
No.
But when you touch it, do you get the feeling of a fire?
Yes.
So that's what had happened with Tukaram. You all have seen his movie? How many of you have seen his movie? At least after this trip, please go back and watch Sant Tukaram movie. It's a famous historical movie which has been made on the life of this very, very renowned devotee of Lord Vitthal, who would come walking for every dindi. You know what I mean by dindi? Okay, let me come to now dindi one. So Tukaram is one. Tukaram is one of the devotees, the great devotees of Lord Vitthala. And there is Gyandev, there is Dhyaneshwar, there is Namdev, there is Sakubai, there is Janabai. While you're walking in the building today, you saw those paintings.
Yes.
The lady was tied up to the pole, right?
Sakubai.
Yeah, she's Sakubai. So like that, there are many stories we will see tomorrow morning, but we'll be going to hear about them either today or tomorrow. So there was this demon called Dindira. So this Dindira was troubling all the three worlds. Now, मैं कई बार ये सुनती थी ना तो मुझे लगता था ये कैसे होता है ट्रबलिंग ऑल द थ्री वर्ल्ड्स. तो आई हैड टू रियली ब्रेक इट डाउन टू माई लेवल्स, जस्ट लाइक द मदर्स ब्रेक अप द यू नो द बारबेक्यू. आई मीन है दिन हमारे सेरेलैक बेबीज के और हमारी मम्मी अगर हमको बारबेक्यू खिलाएगी तो कैसे होगा, हमारा डाइजेशन सिस्टम कैसे चलेगा, राइट? सो सिमिलरली दिस बिग फिलोसफी दैट वी आर नॉट एबल टू कोरिलेट विद एंड अंडरस्टैंड एंड डाइजेस्ट, वी हैव टू ब्रेक इट इनटू स्मॉल पीसेस. दैट्स व्हाट वी डू इन मैथ्स, that's what we do in geometry, that's what we do in algebra. We break the entire thing into different sections. Pehle ek answer, phir dusra answer, phir teesra answer, right? So वैसे ही ये दिंडीरवन जो पूरे तीन मतलब तीन भुवन को जो trouble करता था, he is like some person from your house जो नाक में दम करके रख देता है. Possible है? घर में सुना है आपने ये?
Yes.
नाक में दम करके रख दिया है इसने तो, right? And कभी कभी हम किसी class में भी सुनते हैं, teacher भी बोलती है, ये एक बच्चा पूरे क्लास का वाट लगा देता है. सुना है? राइट. देन वी ऑल्सो हियर इन द टाउन, यू नो, ये एक बिल्डिंग पूरे सोसाइटी को खराब कर देती है. सुना है?
Yes.
एक राज्य में एक, आई शुड नॉट से पार्टी, बट देन सम सेक्शन ऑफ पीपल, उन्होंने नाक में दम करके रख दिया, पूरा कबाड़ा कर दिया है हमारे धर्म का. मान सकते हो?
Yes.
तो वैसे ही एक दिंडीर पूरे तीन भुवन में कबाड़ा नहीं कर सकता. कर सकता है, पोटेंशियल है, हमें समझता नहीं है, उसको हमने इतना इजिली ब्रेक डाउन किया नहीं है, राइट? सो दिस दिंडीर वाज ट्रबलिंग इन ऑल द थ्री वर्ल्ड्स एंड लॉर्ड शिवा वाज अप्रोच टू किल हिम. सो ही कम्स, नॉट दिंडीर, सॉरी, लॉर्ड विष्णु वाज आस्क्ड टू किल हिम, बट लॉर्ड विष्णु सेड आई कांट कम डायरेक्टली टू किल हिम बिकॉज आई हैव गिवन हिम द बेनेडिक्शन कि मैं डायरेक्ट नहीं आऊंगा. सो देन द मून गॉड वाज रिक्वेस्टेड, द मून गॉड हैड परफॉर्म तपस्या, ही वॉन्टेड टू हैव लॉर्ड विष्णु एज अ सन. So Lord Vishnu takes the birth of son of moon god and then he comes to kill this Dindira demon. And when he comes to kill this Dindira demon, just because he came in touch with the Lord, just like Putana, she had come to kill the Lord. But by the time she got killed by the Lord, she was completely transformed into being a Dhatri for the Lord. Dhatri means nurse.
Yes.
Right? So whatever comes in touch with the Lord has to be purified and transformed. That is the potential of the Lord. Just like when we were sitting in Thakvitoba temple and we were doing Kirtan, we all were touched, right? I mean, the vibrations were so high that it took us to another world altogether. So similarly here also, because Dindira came in touch with Lord Vishnu directly, his heart totally transformed. And then the Lord, even Vali also had that heart transformation before giving up his body. So the Lord asked him, please ask for a benediction. And this Dindira says, because actually the Lord makes a iron mace to kill him.
So there is also Lohavan and Vrindavan. I'm not sure how many of you have been there. So Lohavan means what? Lohe ka kabhi van nahi hota hai. But when the Lord uses an iron mace, an iron club to kill the demon, that place becomes Lohavan. So similar thing happened here also. The Lord had taken iron mace to kill this Dindira. And therefore the Lord said, here the demon said, who was now by now transformed into a devotee, that this place should be known as Loha Danda Tirtha. Because you punished me with the iron mace and I got transformed, this place from the troublesome place has transformed into a Tirtha. It has very beautiful analogy. All our hearts are troubled. How many of you have a free heart here? When I say free heart, doesn't mean you have those lines going up, down. When I don't mean, you know, you have free cholesterol, free from cholesterol, no. How many of you have free heart here? What do you mean by free heart? Free of material desires, which is too much to expect at this age when we have all kinds of, you know. It's okay, fine. We have to break it down at our level. What do you mean by free hearts? Oh, very good. हम लोग अभी तक इसी दुनिया में हैं. थोड़ा ऊपर उठो. Free from the unwanted conditionings. जो मेरा जीवन देने वाला है, जो मेरा भाग्य देने वाला है, वो तो वैसे भी मेरे कंट्रोल में नहीं है. But जो मेरे कंट्रोल में है, वो है मेरा मन. So we are yet contaminated with all these conditionings of anger, jealousy, envy, pride. राइट right? उसको मिला मुझे क्यों नहीं मिला, ये इतनी सुंदर मैं क्यों इतनी सुंदर नहीं, इसके पास ऐसे चप्पल मेरे पास क्यों नहीं, इसके पास ये इयर रिंग मेरे पास क्यों नहीं, इसके इतने फॉलोअर्स मेरे क्यों नहीं, मैं अकेली बैठती तो कोई मेरे पास नहीं आता, ये अकेली बैठती तो 10 लोग जाते हैं, सब इसका फैन फॉलोइंग क्यों करते हैं मेरे पास कोई. दिस इज वॉट वी स्टिल हैव अ डिजीज्ड हार्ट. राइट, सो वेन वी कम इन टच विद द लॉर्ड, अ ट्रबल सम डिजीज्ड हार्ट कैन ऑल्सो हैव द पोटेंशियल टू बिकम अ तीर्थ. Which is what we learn from this Dindira pastime. Just because he came in touch with the Lord, his heart got transformed and he requested to the Lord, a troublesome place like this Dindir, I mean where I was residing, it became Dindira 1 later on, this troublesome place, please transform it into a beautiful Tirtha, which got transformed because of Loha Danda, the iron mace which you used upon me. So that iron mace in our life is our chanting, our hearing, our association, our services. So when we have that danda, because Lord Krishna is not different from his name, Lord Krishna is not different from his Navada Bhakti. What is Navada Bhakti? Shravanam, Kirtanam, Vishnu, Smaranam, Sevanam, Archanam, Vandanam, Dasyam, Sakyam, Adhmanam. So these 9 processes of devotional service act like that danda, which clean our heart, which transform our troublesome heart into a wonderful Tirtha. The second benediction he asked is, please call this entire place after me, so that people get to know for the rest of the eternity that even a demon like me can become transformed by coming in association with you, by coming in touch with you, by getting your association. So that's why this place became Dindira 1. So once in Dwaraka, now let's go to the west. Once in Dwaraka, Krishna was residing with all his queens. And as you all know, that every night, Krishna would remember the gopis. Even during the daytime, he would. But night time, हमारे साथ भी होता है ना, दिन में बहुत सारी चीजें मन में चल रही होती है. बट आप बेड पे जाते हो तो सारी चीजें ऐसे एक्टिव हो जाती है. So even Krishna went to the bed and he would remember the gopis of Vrindavan and the Vrajvasis of Vrindavan so intensely that by the next morning when he would wake up, the queens would always see his pillows wet. And generally we also used to wet the beds. But that's a different kind of wetting. Here when he would wet the pillows, the queens would wonder what makes these pillows so wet. Is it his perspiration? No, not at all. The Lord is Satchidananda Vigraha. His perspiration can convert into Viraja River. Not Viraja River, Garbhodaka Ocean. Right? What is Garbhodaka Ocean? It's the perspiration of Lord Mahavishnu. So he said that's the power of his perspiration. This pillow would not be suffice to take and absorb his perspiration. So definitely it has to be his intense love in separation for the gopis that would make cry tears for the Lord, from the eyes of the Lord, and that would wet the pillows. So the queens would all, and that's when they went to Mother Rohini and said, please tell us that our Lord is constantly crying the names of Radha, Lalita, Vishakha, Maiya, Yashoda. He's staying with us only for name's sake.
His body is with us, but his soul is always with
Vrindavan.
In Vrindavan, with all the residents there in Vrindavan. So please narrate the pastimes of Vrindavan. And that's how we have Jagannath Baladev Subhadra's story, which is Mahaprakash Bhav. So once it is said in one of the Loka Katha. See, Loka Katha is not maybe not directly from the Puranas and the Shastras, but the senior authorities believe that if Loka Katha is in line with our scriptural understanding, we can happily accept it. So we can very well accept it. Thank you so much. So once it so happened that the Vrajvasis came to meet Krishna at Kurukshetra, at Dwarka. And when they saw the palaces and the big, jewel-studded beds and the throne and very well decorated, very opulently dressed, all the Dwarka Vasis, they were like little, I won't say feeling inferior, but they were really little embarrassed. Ki itne bade bade logon ke beech mein hum kya hai? But as we discussed in Takpite Vitoba temple, that luxury and opulence is just part of life. Devotion is the essence of life, which the Vrajvasis carried, and they depicted it to the highest extent possible. So these Vrajvasis, when Radharani came and all the gopis came, Krishna was sitting with her and dealing very intimately, as if he's reunited with his lover after a long time. So the queens happened to see this. Is there any other pastime where Krishna was treating some of his other devotees very intimately and the queens came to interrupt?
Sudama.
Very good. What was Krishna doing with him? He was washing his feet, he was feeding him, he was fanning him. And the queens were like, "Bas, you are Dwarka Dhish. This is all supposed to be done by your servants." And what Krishna says? Servants are meant for Dwarka. For Vrindavan, I am available. I am there. The service of Vrajvasis is my right. We all sing every morning, Seva Adhikara Diye Karo Nija Dasi. We pray to Vrindadevi Tulsi Maharani. So our right is to serve the devotees, to serve the Lord. But Krishna says, Vrajvasis, who has the right to serve? I have the right to serve. Rest of the opulence is meant for all of you and for me. But I am meant for them. Right? A is equal to B, B is equal to C. Therefore, A is equal to C. Math, stats, algebra, geometry, geography, science, everything is best applied in Krishna consciousness to the extent of each and every Bollywood song that you sing. The old songs. Aajkal ke songs mein kuch meaning nahi hai. Right? So, but the old songs which we used to hear, when you experience Krishna conscious moments, blissful moments, you can connect with it so very beautifully, and then you feel, wo song shayad unhone yahan se churaya tha, is leela se churaya tha. So like that, A is equal to B, B is equal to C. All my stats, all my algebra comes to life when I talk about all these things in Krishna consciousness. So when Krishna says that you are meant for me, but I am meant for Vrajvasis. Therefore, what they aspire, they also want to serve Vrajvasis. A is equal to B, B is equal to C. Therefore, A is equal to
C.
So he was so intimately serving Radharani and all the other Vrajvasis that Rukmini Devi, for a moment, which is very unusual of her, she felt a little upset because she was the closest queen of King Krishna. I mean, the Lord Dwarkadish there. So she felt a little disappointed, and it is said she left her Dwarka palace and she came to this particular place of Dindiravan to perform tapasya in anger. And in that embarrassment, that Krishna is loving, his love for Srimati Radharani is so high, so intimate, and so much at a highest pedestal that I felt, in fact, it is said when Lakshmi also left, any other pastime, Lakshmi and Bhrugumuni pastime, when Lakshmi also leaves, Tirupati pastime, right? So when she also leaves to perform tapasya, it's not just because she's angry at Bhrugu. A lady is not always confused. She's always mixed with feelings. Why? Because you feel naturally jealous, envy when something is going, not as per your desire. At the same time, the lady tattva in you, the stri tattva in you does not allow you to remain on that platform for a long time. And then you condemn yourself for having aroused such feelings. How could I feel angry? How could I chastise? Mothers, what do they do with us? They first slap us, they chastise us, or they punish us. And who repents? More than us, they only repent, they only regret, why did I do that with my child? So that's by nature, ladies like that. So if ever you're confused, you give yourself a proclamation or a declaration, I am a lady.
Right? Don't demean it. Just say yourself, oh, I prove I'm a lady. Right? But then, of course, you have to take guidance. How to come out of that confusion. Don't remain in that confusion. That means you're a foolish lady. If you come out of it, then you're an intelligent lady. Okay, so Mother Lakshmi also comes out having that anger for Bhrigu and also feeling, how could I see the offense towards my lord? So she had mixed feelings, positive feeling and the negative feeling also, the guilt feeling also. So similarly here also when Mother Rukmini leaves Dwarka, she has this mixed feeling. What is the feeling? Oh, Krishna loves Radharani much more than me. So that little bit of that embarrassment is there, that awkward situation is there. But on the second hand, she also feels that what can I do? I'm still not qualified to get that rasa from Krishna. So she wants to qualify. She never wants to become equal to Radharani, but she feels I need to perform more tapasya for it. That I can also become that dear to serve Sri Krishna. So in a very hasya parihasya ka anger hai. Lakshmi ke jaise anger nahi hai. Hasya parihasya ka anger hai. Kabhi hota hai na, ghar mein jhagda ho jata hai, to maa ek room mein jaake baith jati hai. Not like Kaikeyi's Kopa Bhavan. Like jhagda ho ke nikal jati hai and then phir thodi der mein mummy ke yahan jaake do din rehti hai aur phir wapas aahi jati hai. So that kind of, maan she had. So she comes to this place called Dindiravan and Lord Krishna when he realizes ki ye vrajvasi jaane ke baad yaad to aata hai ya na. जो आपके मेहमान है वो थोड़े ही दिन के मेहमान है, उसके बाद घर वाले ही आपको काम आने वाले हैं. सो दिस इज इंटेलिजेंस. मेहमानों का बहुत आदर सत्कार करो, बट घर वालों का अपमान करोगे तो वो जाने के बाद आपको भी निकल जाना पड़ेगा. राइट? सो हैव ऑलवेज अ बैलेंस बिटवीन बोथ. सो कृष्णा ऑल्सो लीव्स एंड ही रन्स आफ्टर मदर रुक्मिणी टू फाइंड वेयर शी इज, बिकॉज बाय द टाइम ही रियलाइज्ड, बाय द टाइम द रजवासी इज लेफ्ट द्वारका, ही कुड नॉट इवन रियलाइज दैट रुक्मिणी हैज लेफ्ट द प्लेस इन एंगर. So then he also follows her and he comes to this particular place looking for her. Where is Rukmini? Where is Rukmini? Where is Rukmini? So at a place where we'll be crossing the river tomorrow and going on a small island kind of a thing. So that place is called Gopalapur. So that place of Gopalapur is the place where the Lord had come to search for Mother Rukmini. And then it is said, when the Vrajvasis, they had not just left, they were just around and he realized Rukmini is not there. So the Vrajvasis say, why are you in anxiety? What happened? And he says, Rukmini is missing. And I can't put any poster because I am the Paramatma in everyone's heart. So I have to go and find her. Lost and found. Aisa kuch possible nahi hai. Mujhe hi jaake dhoondna padega. Unko kaun dhoond sakta hai? Because even Lakshmi went into the waters to perform tapasya once upon a time when she was separated from Vishnu. So, when Krishna says, I have to go find her, all the Vrajvasis say, we have not done any yatra with you for a long time. Can we come along with you for a yatra? So Krishna says, okay, fine, no problem. So all the Vrajvasis, so he takes the form of cowherd boy, not that King Krishna. So they go back to their Vrindavan days. And then Krishna takes the stick in his hand, the cows and the calves for grazing. And Nanda Baba, Yashoda and all the gopis, they come on to this particular place of Gopalapur, the island where we'll be going tomorrow. So where Krishna stands with his stick stuck on the ground, that place is still there. That stone is completely melted. Krishna plays his flute and the stone is completely melted because the stone is, Govardhan has so many places like that. Whenever Krishna plays the flute, even the non-moving objects start moving. And the moving objects become stable, static, right? So when Krishna was playing the flute with his stick stuck on the ground, with his cows around, cows and the calves around, so that place became complete, that stone became completely melted. So tomorrow morning when you go there, please take that darshan. You'll see the stick, you'll see the hoof print of the calf and the cow and Krishna's lotus footprint. That's why this place is also considered as non-different than Gaya, Vishnu Path. Because here Sakshat Bhagwan Krishna ke charan chinh hai. So here they had their lunch together. Ab socho wo aaye kyun the Rukmini ko dhundne ke liye. Aur aake phir se yahan pe busy ho gaye. Right? But they had this pastime. So I always felt, Bhagwan aise alag alag prant mein kyun jaate hain? Because it is said everybody can't go to Vrindavan. Everybody can't go to Kashi. Right? Therefore, the Lord makes this arrangement in every small, small prant, every small, small regions, so that the local people can also get exposed and have an access to pure devotional service. Therefore, if you see, Krishna's presence is there in almost all the countries all over, all the states all over the country. So he performs that lunch pastimes here at Gopalapur. And then suddenly he realizes Rukmini ko dhundna hai. So then he goes finding Rukmini ko dhundna hai. And Rukmini is not able to find because wo maan hi nahi rahi hai. And Rukmini, I mean, this is a little subtler and deeper aspect, but still I will talk about it. Jitne ko samajhta hai samajh lo, jitne to jaise maine kaha, sun ke register kar lo. Kuch cheeze kuch saalon ke baad realize hoti hai. I'm very bad at keeping the focus. For me, one point takes to the other point, and then takes to the other point, and then takes to the other point, and then have to ask, where was I? Why did I begin with this? So you come across many a times, quite often this. And then I should not brag about it very proudly. It's my shortcoming. But then I have learned this so-called learning from my spiritual master, His Holiness Radhika Swami Maharaj, who takes one point, and then he goes back to some other point, and then he goes back to some other point, and then he has to ask, you know, where was I? And unknowingly, I realized that I have also fallen into the same habit because I've been hearing him for the last 25, 30 years. So, okay, where was I? Subtler, yeah, deeper understanding. So, it is said, in fact, at the end of today's talk, if these management people allow, I wanted to sing a very beautiful song on Rakumai. Rakumai, 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 Rakumai. It's a very beautiful song. Maybe I'll share the YouTube link also later on. But this highlights the capacity and the potential, the importance of Mother Rukmini. We have taken Mother Rukmini's darshan today in the main temple also and Takpitavitoba also. So it is said, Shri Lakshmi and Radharani and all her expanded energies, they possess and control the Lord. They have the power to reveal the Lord to us to such an extent that if they decide to hide themselves from the Lord, even the Lord cannot find them. Because to that extent, they can control the Lord. They can make the Lord go mad in their separation. Even the Lord cannot find them. His Paramatma feature fails. What is Paramatma feature? Upadrishta and Anumanda. As Paramatma, he resides in everyone's heart. Of course, in Golok Vrindavan, in spiritual world, there is no Paramatma. But as Paramatma, he can know, right, where, who is hiding. Wo ek story, see, again, going back to one more story bhi hai na. Drona kehte hain Pandavon ko aur Kauravon ko, jao, ye sep kha kar aao, jahan par tumko koi nahi dekh raha hai. And all the Pandavas and Kauravas go and Duryodhan tries to has the best hideout place. Jahan par usko koi nahi dekh raha hai. Cave ke andar, jahan pe koi nahi hota hai, jahan ki wo apple ya banana jo bhi dete hain guru, wo kha ke aata hai. And all the Pandavas try their, you know, hideouts, bushes ke behind, idhar udhar, jahan pe koi nahi dekh raha hai, kha ke sab wapas aa jate hain. Only one person comes back, sincere, integrated person. Who was that?
Yudhishthira.
He comes back with that phal and he tells to his spiritual master very, very regretfully and very, very embarrassed and disappointed. I'm so sorry, my dear Guru. I could not finish this apple. So the Guru asks, why you could not finish this apple? Did you not find even a single place in this entire Hastinapur to hide yourself? He says, no, the places are many to hide. But main jahan bhi chupu, Paramatma to hamesha mere saath aate hain. And then that's how he proved that he had deep wisdom right from childhood. So the Guru wanted to teach the lesson to the entire 104 brothers, that this is what I wanted to teach you, which I did not want to say, but I just want you to understand and observe, which is what we are going to do with the Dindi, the Pundalik pastime now. So where was I again? With the Rukmini. Yeah, so even as Paramatma feature, the Lord cannot find where is Mother Rukmini, because she decides when she can reveal and when she can not reveal, when she can hide herself. This is the power of love. Ladies ke shakti ko nazar andaz nahi karna chahiye. Agar mummy ne decide kar liya, aaj khana nahi banega, to nahi hi banega. You all agree? Aaj mummy ne decide kar liya, aaj khichdi hi banni hai, to kya banega?
Khichdi
hi banegi. Of course, she sacrificed a lot for you, as bachpan mein bahut sare aapke tantrums ko sahan kiya hai, aapke bahut sare desires ko fulfill kiya hai. But when she comes to Durga roop, nobody can defeat her. Right? So that's why mother is a form of Nava Durga, Navaratri, which we say, because a lady is a... See, when I say mother, even you are going to end up there, one day or the other. Right? And you have already faced it. So just try to combine everything. You know, you appreciate your mother and you prepare yourself for your next journey, for your next landmark in your life. So, Mother Rukmini decided, I'm not going to appear in front of Krishna, kitna bhi mujhe dhoondi. And especially agar maan mein chale jaye na, ladies, lovers, premika agar maan mein chale jaye na, to premi naak bhi ragde, to bhi kuch farak nahi padta. Ek bar Radharani aise ruthi thi Vrindavan mein.
And then he went like, Krishna used to take so many forms. Sometimes he would become the bangles wala, sometimes he would become a sannyasi, sometimes he would become a, you know, chas wala, or so many other forms just to, sometimes he would take the form of peacock to pacify Srimati Radharani. And somehow Radharani would just become, you know, besieged, chalo, maan gayi, main bahut easily maan bhi jati thi. But this particular day, because he came late, Radharani bhi maan mein hoti hai. So then she was not ready to be pacified. So Krishna was so disappointed that he went to Keshi Ghat and sat like this. There's a picture of this, huh, which Prabhupada disciples painted. Krishna sat like this. Kya karu, Radharani nahi maan rahi hai. And suddenly there Paurnamasi comes. Because Paurnamasi is none other than Yogamaya's expansion. So there are two people who always help Krishna in Vrindavan. Paurnamasi and Yogamaya. Paurnamasi helps on the Vatsalya Sakhyaras. And Yogamaya helps, Vrindadevi helps in Madhuryaras. So Paurnamasi comes and says, ye to Madhuryaras ka problem hai. मैं कुछ नहीं कर सकती क्योंकि मेरा वात्सल्य और साख्य में ज्यूरिसडिक्शन है. तो तुम एक काम करो, वृंदा देवी के पास जाओ. सो वृंदा देवी के पास कृष्णा जाते हैं एंड वो कहते हैं, क्या करूं, राधा रानी मान ही नहीं रही है, बोलो कुछ तो उपाय बोलो, आज तो हद हो गई, यू नो शी इज नॉट अग्रीइंग फॉर एनीथिंग. सो देन वृंदा देवी सेज, इतनी आसानी से नहीं मानने वाली है, आज नाक रगड़ना पड़ेगा. बोलो क्या करना पड़ेगा, मैं नाक क्या सर दीवार सब रगड़ने के लिए तैयार हूँ, बोलो क्या करना है. सो वृंदा देवी टेकिंग द एडवांटेज ऑफ द अपॉर्चुनिटी शी सेज, सबसे पहले तो तुम्हारी वो नो हमारी जो दुश्मन वो जो मुरली है ना उसको पहले त्याग दू. सो कृष्णा सेज, मुरली इज माय आइडेंटिटी, इट्स माय लाइफ एंड सोल, जिसे मैं तुम सबको अपने कंट्रोल में करता हूँ, इसीलिए तो मांग रही हूँ, दे दो. सो कृष्णा जस्ट टेक्स ऑफ एंड गिव्स इट टू वृंदा देवी. देन ही सेज, अब जाओ. बोले नहीं, अभी बाकी है वो तुम्हारा मनमोहक पिकॉक फेदर, जिसको देख के हम तुम्हारे पीछे पीछे पूरे दुनिया के चर अचर वस्तु तुम्हारे पीछे पीछे भागने लगते हैं, उसको निकालो. ये मेरा अस्तित्व है, आई गेट डिफरेंशिएटेड बिकॉज ऑफ दिस मोरपंख. गलती से एक बार मधुमंगल ने वो मोरपंख डाल लिया था और केशी डीमन ने उसको अटैक कर लिया था, ये सोच के ये कृष्ण है. उस दिन मधुमंगल ने कहा, ये लो तुम्हारी मुरली, ये लो तुम्हारा मोरपंख, ये तुम्ही को सचता है, तुम्ही को जमता है, और कोई इसको हैंडल नहीं कर सकता, बिकॉज कहां वहां पे दानव आ जाते हैं. सो शी सेज, राधा रानी चाहिए ना, गिव बैक. सो देन ही गिव्स द पीकॉक फेदर ऑल्सो. And then finally she's up. Then he says, "Can I go now?" Vrinda Devi says, "No, अभी तक नाक रगड़ा ही नहीं है." Then she says, "ये जो तुम्हारा रूप है ना त्रिभंग, the most cruelly enchanting and killing रूप, the most killing रूप of yours, तुम्हारा त्रिभंग. I know a girl from Chennai who says, Mataji, whenever I see the tribhanga hip of Krishna, I feel like licking his tribhanga." ऐसे ऐसे अट्रैक्शन होते हैं लोगों के. लिकिंग मींस इट्स सो स्वीट लाइक हनी टू अब्सॉर्ब दैट फॉर्म दैट आई फील लाइक जस्ट टेकिंग इट, यू नो, जस्ट टेकिंग इट इन ऑफ माइंड. सो ही सेज, त्रिभंग भी छोड़ना पड़ेगा. अरे दैट्स द ओनली वे आई एंड विष्णु आर आइडेंटिफाइड और डिस्टिंग्विश्ड. विष्णु स्टैंड स्ट्रेट एंड आई स्टैंड इन त्रिभंगा एंड आई स्टैंड इट फॉर यू. एंड तीन जगह पे टेढ़ा है, इसलिए तो लोग मुझे टेढ़ा भगवान बोलते हैं, तुम मेरा अस्तित्व निकाल रहे हो. सो अगेन वृंदा देवी सेज, डू यू वांट राधारानी और नॉट. He had to do it. And then finally she says, remove your pitambar. अरे बोले इज्जत निकाल देगी क्या, मुझे पता है मैंने तुम्हारे कपड़े उतारे थे, बट इसका मतलब ये नहीं तुम भी मेरे ही कपड़े उतारो, ऐसे ही बदला रहो. तो she says, no, 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 you have to take the form of a sannyasi. You have to just take the sannyasi robes. And then he has wraps around him the, क्या कहते हैं उसको, गेरुआ, right? The saffron color. So like this, even Krishna, and then he goes in the form of a sannyasi and the story continues, which we'll take up in some other camp. But then, this is how Krishna को भी नाक रगड़ना पड़ता है अगर उनको राधा रानी का दर्शन चाहिए तो. तो यहाँ पर तो रुक्मिणी रूठ के बैठी है, तो कृष्णा आने के लिए तैयार ही नहीं है रुक्मिणी. सो देन कृष्णा सेज, अरे ये तो मान ही नहीं रही है. तो मीनवाइल व्हाट ही डिड, ही हैड हिज लंच. एंड देन रुक्मिणी फेल्ट और गुस्सा हो गई. अब मैं आ नहीं रही हूं तो मुझे मनाने के बदले वो क्या कर रहे हैं, और बैठकर एंजॉय कर रहे हैं. सो फाइनली कृष्णा सेज, यहाँ पे चलो बहुत हास्य परिहास हो गया, लंच भी हो गया. देन सडनली ही कम्स अक्रॉस अ वेरी ब्यूटिफुल फीलिंग अराउंड. यू ऑल फील वाइब्रेशंस, यू ऑल सेंस, सिक्स्थ सेंस, लेडीज आर नोन फॉर इट. कुछ अच्छे वाइब्रेशंस होते हैं तो तुरंत ऐसे हार्ट कान सब कुछ जाग जाता है. तो कृष्ण व्हेन ही फिनिश्ड एंजॉयिंग विद हिज रजवासीज एंड ही ऑलरेडी ट्राइड टू पर्सुएड रुक्मिणी देवी व्हिच ही वाज नॉट रेडी टू यू नो मानो, देन ही थॉट he just was attacked or he was attracted, he was pulled by a very beautiful feeling of servitorship, of devotion,
और उनका दिल वहां पे भागने लगा, उनका मन वहां पे भागने लगा। जैसे हम किसी अच्छी चीज के प्रति आकर्षित होकर भागते हैं, तो कृष्ण का भी मन उस ओर खींचने लगा। एंड व्हाट वाज दैट? एन ऑफरिंग ऑफ डिवोशन। एंड दैट प्लेस हैपेंड टू बी द पुंडलिक दर्शन विच वी टुक इन द मॉर्निंग। आफ्टर द मेन टेम्पल्स दर्शन वी वेंट टू अ स्मॉल प्लेस जहां पे शिवा विद स्नेक वॉज देयर एंड देयर वॉज दिस वन फेस। सो दैट इज पुंडलिक्स हाउस। So this Pundalik was a great devotee of Lord Krishna. But then how Panduranga or how Krishna became Panduranga comes in connection with this Pundalik story. So how exactly it happened when Krishna sensed that devotion, you know, that vibrations of devotion, love, sacrifice, care for somebody, that feeling of surrender for someone, Krishna became attracted to it. But before I request the drama girls to be ready. But before I just hand over the stage to the drama girls, I would also want to share that anything that is worth in this life, in this world, in this entire creation is meant for Krishna. So when Krishna sensed that beautiful feeling of love, devotion, samarpan, care, service, he got attracted. Although it was happening for somebody else, but he got attracted towards it and he came running as if pulled by that feeling of devotion. Why? Because anything that is existing is worth to be offered to Krishna. So when he comes to this particular Pundalik's place, he stands there and he sees that there's this young boy who's serving his parents very, very diligently, as if they are his deities. You know, more than the Lord himself, he was offering his heart's love, care, attention and service to his parents. The Lord became impressed by him. Very, very impressed by him. And then because Pundalik was absorbed and immersed in his service to his parents, diligent service to his parents, then the Lord wanted to give him a hint, because for a long time, see, what you do comes back. Right? Rukmini was waiting there, but Krishna didn't come. I mean, Krishna did not, he did not become successful to pacify her. So then Rukmini became more angry. Similarly now, here Krishna is waiting. For whom?
Pundalik.
For Pundalik to turn back towards him. Jaisi karni,
vaisi
bharni. Right? So he also had, of course, this is a spiritual realm. This is not karma principle. Whatever happens with Krishna is leela. It's motivated by love. It's motivated to teach us. Right? But what jaisi karni, vaisi bharni, when we follow, it's all about our karma principle getting back to us. So even Krishna had to wait. So when Pundalik ko unhone knock kiya ki I'm waiting at your doorstep. So Pundalik was absorbed in massaging the feet of his parents. And when he hears a call behind at the door, what he says, whoever it is, take this brick and stand, wait, I'll be there. Like he did, meaning to say that I can't leave the service of my parents right now, which is massaging my parents' lotus feet, my parents' body. And now I can't disrespect you also because there's a atithi at the door. Atithi Devo Bhava. So I want to balance both. So what he did, he took a brick which was lying nearby and he just threw it. Can you imagine Pundalik ka ghar kidhar hai aur Vithoba kahan khade hai? Kya long throw ke skills hai? We used to have the sports, throws, right? What is that game called? Throw.
Javelin.
Right? So that's how Pundalik just threw the brick and said, please wait patiently while I attend to my parents diligently. So the Lord chose to wait for Pundalik to finish his service to his parents and then attend to him. And that's why the Lord residing here is called Vit Ubha. Jo Vit means brick and Ubha means one who is standing in Marathi. Vithobha. Okay, so that's how he's called as Vithoba. So now who's this Pundalik? How did he end up here? How his life was, a total 180 degree shift from being a cruel son to a very, very devoted son. So much so that the Lord got impressed by his devotion towards his parents. So let's see this in the beautiful drama which the girls are going to present.
I can sit in the chair.